Back again with another reaction. I am going to be reacting to a Nuke's top 5 10 scary videos of ghosts. Y'all already know. Spooky season. So, need y'all to do me a favor before we get to watch this video. I need you to get your snacks and your drinks, head to the couch with your boy, and watch this video. Let's go.
Factory worker Kamikaeli recently moved from his home country of Greenland to live and work in Denmark. But little did he know that the apartment he moved into had a horribly dark past. 7 years ago, a 49-year-old man was brutally attacked and lost his life right outside the apartment's front door. After Kama moves in, he begins to notice his things moving and falling to the floor for no reason. He hears the creepy sound of someone knocking on his door, and doors inside the apartment slam shut for no reason. One afternoon, Kama hears strange sounds coming from somewhere inside his apartment. He pulls out his phone and starts to record as he tries to find the source of the odd noises. But then, this happens.
Now, I got a question. The event that occurred to the person that passed, being that happened outside the building, why is he getting all these activities? Now, I'm wondering, does everybody else seem to get these activities as well? I think he shags. Because if so, then he's not alone. You get me? So I would ask. This is broad daylight, man.
Kama gets a good jump scare as a door slams shut right in front of him. And it seems to literally scare a fart right out of him.
Oh, wow.
But now, this is where the fun ends and things start to get really dark. Because another day, not long after sunset, the eerie activity in the apartment starts up once again. Now, Kama is a bit scared, but once again, he takes out his phone to try to record proof of the creepy activity in his apartment. What happens next is truly creepy.
Thank you.
chamber door opens by itself and Kama's helmet slides across the floor. Later that night, Kama decides to live stream from his apartment. He says that he's having trouble sleeping because he keeps hearing things moving and falling to the floor over in the next room.
Yo, it's crazy. It's like, do you guys have friends? Some of these people that go through these things. And I know it might be late, but bro, that is a late call, man. That's when you use that late call ticket. Yo, can I come crash at the spot? Like, you're dealing with this shit, and that's just terrifying to go through that. Now you're getting lack of sleep, can't function properly. Like, that's crazy.
What happens next, live on camera, is downright chilling.
Up out of there. He hauled ass out of there. I thought it was something in the window.
Caught live on stream, Kama hears the sounds of his belongings falling to...
Bro. Listen, I'm going back. Yo, it's something in the window. It's literally something in the window. Let me go back. Look.
Caught live on stream, Kama hears the sounds of his belongings.
Yo, that shit just disappeared.
He's falling to the floor in the other room. But when he goes to investigate, the drawers of a small cupboard slide open on their own. Kama's had enough and runs down the stairs and out of the building. But when he looks up,
I know Nuke had to see that. He had to.
Up at his apartment window, he is shocked to see someone or something standing inside his apartment. Seemingly looking right down at him. So with everything that has happened, could Kama's apartment actually be haunted by the restless ghost
Fuck
of
yeah.
the man whose life was
Fuck yeah, that shit's haunted.
Taken there? Let me know what you think. Just a quick side note, but Greenlandic is only spoken by around 57,000 people in the entire world. So a huge thank you to Nuke's Top 5 viewer Wilhelm for translating. Nuke's Top 5 Viewer Videos. Nuke's Top 5 Viewer Natalie Hintz is taking a few iPhone Live photos of her sister-in-law and niece at a scenic lookout in Utah when suddenly she notices something very odd.
Yo, this motherfucking bike is riding by itself.
When Natalie watches the live photos back, she notices a bicycle riding by at an alarming speed in the background, all on its own. There's no rider, and there's no one chasing the runaway bike. Natalie says she is creeped out by the strange photos. Viewer Steven Figueroa says that he's been experiencing paranormal events since he was 3 years old. He says that he has even seen full-bodied shadow apparitions in his home. So back in 2013, when Steven was 18 years old, he says that he was finally able to capture proof of what he's been experiencing. But it's a bit potato because all he had to record back then was his iPod Touch. Notice that the trash can first tips slightly forward, then moves back, then crashes over onto the floor. A few bags and suitcases fall over as well for no apparent reason. Cut to 2017, and Steven has now upgraded his video with a new phone. When he hears a strange rattling noise coming from the hallway outside his bedroom, he once again decides to try to record some proof of his paranormal experiences. And this is when things start to get really weird.
Well, I think that's a cutout of a person, but that shit just scared me a little bit.
A picture frame on the wall violently moves and raises up, almost as if it's trying to fly right off the wall. Since this video, Steven says that his grandmother cleansed and staged their home, and for the last 6 years, he's happy to report he's never had another paranormal experience.
That's creepy.
This next creepy video was sent in by Nuke's Top 5 viewer, Paulus Hellander. In his email, Paulus says that his brother was home all alone one night at their farm in Finland. Out the window, he notices that the light in the barn has mysteriously turned on. Paulus says that this strange event has happened many times, but no one in his family can figure out why. Now the farm is in the middle of nowhere, and the man is all alone. But nevertheless, he gathers his courage and goes out to turn off the light. He films the barn as he searches for any explanation as to why the light turned on. What happens next is downright creepy.
Real quick, just living on a barn is creepy in itself. Because they have the most craziest shit that happens out in the fields. It's very creepy to me. I will never, ever want to live in or close by a farm. City folk. Something was looking at man's, and now it was gone. Right here. When he pans back, it's gone. See?
Did you see it? A pale, undefined face can be seen staring in through the window of the barn, seemingly watching the man before disappearing into the night. Thankfully, whatever it was seems to have scurried off and the man returned home unharmed. But what do you think this is? Is it something paranormal or perhaps something even more terrifying? A real person stalking around the farm in the middle of nowhere in the dead of night. Hanako-san. A group of friends at a high school in Japan hear crying coming from the restroom during their lunch break. Now, in Japan, there is a famous legend of a girl named Tanako-san. This young girl's spirit is said to haunt restrooms in schools across Japan. The group moves in, all of them a bit hesitant to investigate the source.
For those of you who's watched any of my videos in the past, overseas entities are different. I say this because they're on a different level. It's just different. Different.
Of the creepy sound. Needless to say, it did not go well.
It's like some movie shit, bro. That they should just be hitting like really like the movies, man. Why they tallest look like that though? They tallest look crazy.
Oh! The girls are just about to leave.
Oh man. Oh man, that was fucking good, bro. That shit. Oh my goodness, man. I know he gonna replay it and I don't even wanna see it, but I got to.
Until they suddenly hear a loud bang and go back for a look. The horrifying, distorted face of a young girl can be seen inside one of the restroom stalls. The group runs in fear and the video cuts. Now, unfortunately, there's no source to be found for this video. It appeared on the internet as mysteriously as the Japanese legend. So did the girls capture evidence of Hanako-san? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. The 6-year seal.
That shit was hella creepy, bro.
A girl says that she lives in a spooky house that was built in the early 1800s. She says that as long as she can remember, strange, unexplained things have happened around the home, including odd noises and creepy, unexplained footsteps in the middle of the night. Tragically, the girl's mother passed away inside the house under mysterious circumstances. Soon after, the girl's granddad became convinced that there was something evil inside the home. For unknown reasons, her granddad sealed his bedroom shut, hid the key, and left the house, never to return. The old man's room remained locked off for the next 6 years. Then suddenly, one day the key to the room was found just lying in the open on the living room table, with no explanation as to how it got there. One night, the girl and her friends decide to explore the allegedly haunted house, using a spirit box in hopes of getting some kind of answer from the other side. And that's when things take a very unexpected turn.
If there's anybody with us, can you tell us your name? Oh, y'all heard that.
The girl's sister is unaware of what's going on and simply steps out of the shower to go to her room. The group thinks it's a ghost.
Hey, yo, that's a good one, bro.
freaks the f*** out. But things are about to take a much more sinister turn as the three friends finally decide to unlock and explore her granddad's six-year sealed bedroom.
Oh, it's just a bedroom? Are you going in?
No, I'm getting a bad feeling about this.
I don't feel good.
I seen this.
No, I don't.
I just got so lightheaded.
What is that?
I just got...
Corbin, don't be going through this stuff.
I just got so lightheaded. Oh my god.
Yeah, I know. I got lightheaded as soon as I walked in here.
Yeah.
You are not welcome here.
Oh, my head's itching. I think there's lights in here.
If there's any spirits in here, leave. You are not welcome.
Why is Santa Claus locked up?
That's what
I'm.
That thing's creepy.
Why, Santa? Why you locked it? It could be an object in here.
Yeah.
Do you guys ever think about that? Like, it could be an object. You could just burn the whole room. What are you doing in the closet, dude?
Oh, my back's burning.
Is it really?
Bitch, my back's burning.
I don't know.
Oh my god!
No, you're kidding.
Stop.
No, get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out.
Marks up your back.
Stop.
No, you do.
Stop. You're giving me anxiety.
Oh my f***ing god.
You're kidding, right? You're kidding.
The girls are shocked as their friend seems to get scratched by something inside the room.
It took us like 5 minutes to unlock that door. Like, it wouldn't open. We went in and immediately I felt lightheaded. Didn't you say you didn't feel good?
I did not feel good.
Immediately I felt lightheaded and I was like, okay. But okay, weird. But I was just trying to like play it off, you know, like it's not real.
He said that his back was burning, and as a joke, I was like, oh, imagine if he had scratch marks. And then he had them. And in the video, you obviously can see there was no one near him.
After this terrifying ordeal, the group believes something is very wrong inside that house. They say that they plan on just staying out of that bedroom. But what do you think is going on here? Could there be a dark entity linked to that bedroom? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. Lost soul. In Michoacán, Mexico, a photographer named Paco is waiting in his studio for his friend Eduardo to arrive to work on a project. Paco suddenly hears his friend Eduardo outside his open window, talking loudly to someone on the street. Paco checks his security camera to see what's going on, and just watch.
Remember, I just said this last, I think it was last video. Imagine walking like through your lifetime. Somebody done probably asked you information about something and you done told them. And what if they wasn't real? But to you, they seem like they was real. That's what's happening. I think this happened to at least everyone at least once or twice out their life.
Güey, te juro por Dios, güey. Te lo juro por Dios que un señor me preguntó que dónde era la pinera.
No digas mamadas.
Te lo juro por Dios, güey. Un señor se me acercó y preguntó, oiga, disculpe, ¿dónde es la pinera? Y por eso le explico, le digo que tenía que cruzar y darle más para abajo, güey. Te lo juro. Te lo juro, güey. No, no mames.
Eduardo swears that a man was asking him for directions, but the security footage shows no one there, just an odd white mist. So did Eduardo have a conversation with a ghost or a brief mental breakdown? Because he seems convinced. So let me know what you think. Alice Attic. Amateur paranormal investigator Phil Koch has been posting strange captures from his supernatural explorations for 15 years on YouTube.
What the hell was that? Wait, gotta get the camera.
Okay, something just crashed right next to us.
In fact, I featured Phil's videos on this channel many years ago.
Something just moved behind me.
Now, on this particular night, Phil and his teenage son are performing a paranormal investigation in the attic of an allegedly haunted house.
My bad, y'all. I had to stop going to bed so late.
House in West Allis, Wisconsin. And things get weird.
On the floor. So.
56? 70? Between.
Without them knowing, a voice seems to whisper, go outside.
7, 7, 7, 7.
But what happens next shocks them to their core.
That shit was clear.
It's like 12:30. And I think that it was about an hour since we heard those footsteps coming through here, but I don't know what that was from. What's our average temperature?
It's about 37, 38.
That's why I'm cold. And I'm getting like a 0.2 all the way through the room.
Wait, it's going to 45. There's 50. Oh, I got a 50.
I got a reading here.
Oh, okay.
I got a reading here.
Okay.
Phil and his son have had enough. They just run right out of the attic. But when Phil uploads the video, many viewers claim that they can actually see something sitting in the chair that slides out. But what do you think? The wandering patient. This next video takes place in an allegedly haunted hospital. Now the story goes that the spirit of a little girl who passed away still wanders the hospital halls, unable to move on. Down in the hospital cafeteria, the staff working the late night shift experience something that makes their blood run cold.
Ya deja de jugar, niña.
Ay, no, Dani,
pequeña.
No mames.
Pequeña, que estamos jugando, ven acá.
Ya se fue para allá. Se abrieron las de allá.
Se abrieron las dos.
Ya se salió, a lo mejor.
Ay, no.
Nunca me asusto, pero ahora mire. Nunca me asusto. Y ahora.
Ay, no mames. No, ya.
¿Qué necesitas, pequeña?
No.
¿Ocupas algo?
Ay, no.
Pequeña.
Ya prendió la luz.
Now, the hospital night staff all know the creepy story of the little ghost that supposedly wanders the hospital. So they watch in terror as the cafeteria gates and automatic door open and close on their own, almost as if someone is walking there. But as the doors close, a small dark figure can be seen walking by the doors on the other side. Wow. But whatever it is, it somehow just doesn't trigger the automatic doors. So could the stories be true? And is the hospital indeed haunted by the spirit of a little girl?
Something going on over there.
I leave that up to you to decide. The Madison Seminary. Two teams of paranormal investigators decide to explore the allegedly haunted Madison Seminary in Madison, Ohio. Madison Seminary was built in 1847, and over the years, the building has been used as a school, a hospital, a mental asylum, and even as housing for the grieving families of men who died in the Civil War. With a long, dark history like that, it's no surprise that many ghosts are said to haunt its abandoned halls. So one spirit in particular is said to be that of a very unfriendly doctor who tries to frighten and physically attack anyone who visits Madison Seminary. Now, the team of paranormal investigators has just started to explore the building when investigator Mandy notices something very odd.
You're super red.
What? Am I gonna die?
Wait,
what?
Why? Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, he's super red. Look at that.
Oh, sun just came through.
Pain. Oh, it's a pain.
Oh, what the?
It almost looks like a thumb.
That's weird. What? It's a weird spot too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't even feel anything. Like, it doesn't feel like anything right now.
No, that's weird.
I guess we'll see if it does start to feel like something.
Turn around again?
So it's burning or something?
I mean, it's red.
I know, it doesn't feel like anything. It's weird.
Ghost hunter Steve is shocked to discover that a large red mark has suddenly appeared on the back of his neck. But he says he doesn't really feel a thing. So the group continues upstairs where the angry spirit of the doctor is said to sometimes appear. As they record, they capture something that is downright creepy.
Oh
like a male voice down there. It was like two or three words.
Doctor! Doctor!
It said doctor.
It just said doctor.
Right after we heard a male voice, it said doctor.
Yeah.
So the thing is, he says he doesn't like to be called a doctor because he says he was a surgeon. So people call him a doctor and it makes him angry. So we call him a doctor, usually.
Is there a doctor down there?
So he doesn't like to be called a doctor because he's
a doctor.
Right after we heard a male voice, it said doctor.
Yeah.
So the thing is, he says he doesn't
like to be
called a doctor.
It just said doctor.
Right after we heard.
If y'all could see it.
It was like two or three words.
Doctor! Doctor!
It said doctor.
It just said doctor.
Right after we heard a male voice, it said doctor.
Yeah.
So the thing is, he says he doesn't.
It could have came from them moving something in front. But that joint looked crazy.
I like to be called a doctor because he says he was a surgeon. So people call him a doctor and it makes him angry. So we call him a doctor, usually.
Is there a doctor down there? Did you hear that? I definitely heard a voice coming from down there.
The group hears a male voice coming from somewhere in the attic. But did you see it? Right after the investigators hear a voice and their obelisk ghost box says the word doctor, a small dark figure can be seen running into the attic hallway.
I called it. I seen it.
The ghost hunters don't even notice the odd figure and only see it once they review their footage later. So did they capture the spirit of the old hospital doctor on camera? You decide. You can watch this entire investigation over on the YouTube channel, Ghost Club Paranormal. Caught on camera. Late one night, Claire Mills from Manchester, England gets a notification on her Ring camera that someone is moving around in her front yard. For obvious reasons, Claire is a bit worried, and she immediately checks the camera footage. What she sees sends chills down her spine.
Wow.
A strange white mist can be seen quickly darting down the driveway before disappearing completely. Claire has no idea what to make of this bizarre figure and wonders if she might have caught a ghost on camera. We need scary videos, so if you see something scary that you think would be perfect for the top 5, send it to me at nukestop5@gmail.com. Secret Shopper. Security guard Garamirez Rivera is working the night shift on New Year's Eve at a Bodega Herrera store in Torreon, Mexico. The security guard is a little bit bored and records a video complaining about having to work all alone on New Year's Eve. Suddenly, something very strange happens.
Año nuevo, señores. Feliz año nuevo aquí, encerrado. Aquí dando el rondín. Jales, jale. Sin llorar. Ay, güey. Hijo de su pinche madre. Luego se oyó. Ni pedo, vámonos. Uy. A la chingada. ¿Qué chingos trae ese pinche mojo? No manches. No, no se oye con sensor, valiendo madre. Vámonos mejor. ¿Uy? Uy, güey. Vámonos mejor.
After this creepy occurrence, the security guard is a little freaked out, but just brushes it off. But then, another night at 3:20 in the morning, Rivera thinks he keeps seeing someone walking behind him from the corner of his eye, even though he's the only person in the store. A little spooked, he decides to record himself as he walks through the store, hoping to catch a glimpse of any mysterious intruder that might be following him. What happens next is truly bizarre.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Buenas madrugadas. No, bueno, más bien, estoy nervioso, asustado. Siempre traigo mi celular a la mano. Son las 3:20 de la mañana, me tocó aquí guardia nocturna, Bodega Herrera. Si se fijan, está todo solo. Pero ahorita acabo de ver a alguien allá en la entrada de clientes. Se miró allá por la entrada de clientes, hasta allá, hasta atrás. Y no hay nadie. Yo fui a asomarme y no... No hay nadie. Así lo voy a dejar, a ver si... Pues de pura chingadera se vuelve a ver, ¿no? Y lo vi clarito, clarito. Ya lo vi otra vez. A ver si se alcanza a ver. No, me da miedo ir. A eso que se mira ahí. Eso negro que se ve ahí.
Miren, ¡oh!
Ya se movió. ¡Oh! Está caminando, de hecho, hasta que no manches. Y se sigue moviendo. Es una persona, claro, hasta que miren. No.
It's time to leave. Vámonos. Bro.
Someone or something can be seen lurking behind the creeped out security guard. Now, we cut to a week later, and Rivera is back on another night shift when he spots a little girl aimlessly wandering around outside the supermarket. But before he can approach her, she simply disappears into the night. Given the late hour and the fact that the little girl was all alone, many viewers have speculated that this little girl could have been responsible for the strange occurrences in the store. Some even suggest that she might actually be a ghost.
Wow.
So now a few months go by and things seem to be back to normal at the store. But then Rivera spots a shopping cart doing something a little weird.
¿Qué tal, amigos? ¿Cómo están? Oigan, estoy en mi hora de comida, pero no van a creer, amigos. Ahorita escuché que se movió el carrito. No lo vi. Escuché que ese carrito se movió, amigos. Se escuchó así clarito como si lo hubiera alguien agarrado. Bueno, no sé, a lo mejor son mis nervios. Miren, hasta no sé si se fijan, estoy temblando. Pero sí, clarito escuché que lo movieron, amigos. Clarito. Si yo, pues no alcancé a grabarlo, obviamente. Pero mire, no manches, mira. Chéquense, ustedes me van a decir si soy yo, son mis nervios, no sé. Pero, mire, no manches, amigos. Se movió, el carro se movió. Estoy seguro. Se movió, amigos. Se movió.
As the security guard attempts to capture evidence of the shopping cart moving, a soft voice can be heard saying, "Jugamos?" Which basically translates in English to, "Want to play?"
Que wow. Lo movieron, amigos.
¿Jugamos?
Clarito.
So could it be that the Bodega Herrera store in Torreon is haunted by the spirit of a little girl? Or just what is going on here? I leave it up to you to decide.
I'm not even gonna lie. This was a great, great video. Beginning to end. Good shit. Nuke's top five, y'all. Never a letdown. Hey, if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to your boy. And as always, until next time, love, peace, and good vibes. As always, let's go.